Where the dreams be free. They never rains, but we keep that green. California. Where the love ain't cheap. Sun kissed skin, but we the coldest. We be in the city. LA. I'ma stay rapping all day.
So Wavy Life coming at y'all with a whole nother video. You know I had to bring this to y'all. This was highly requested. Five things that exes do by the title. This is what you clicked on, so I'm gonna give it to you. The first one is they stalk you or your social media. I know we all had some exes that we had as friends, or while you were dating, you had them as a friend. They had their page, of course, and you had yours. Some people don't always delete their ex. Some people do. You know what I mean? It depends on how the breakup was, or depending on how the person is when you break up. Some people don't care about them still being friends with their exes or whatever like that. So they'll still keep them on their page. Some people say, shit, you did what you did. I don't even want to look at you. You know what I mean? So they delete them. You got some people, exes that make a fake page, have their family, have their friends follow you. You know what I mean? All type of stuff. And just try to stalk their social media. You know it's them because you've been in a relationship with them. You know them. You know what I mean? That's one of them. Number two, let me remind y'all, these are not in order. This is just five things, you know what I mean? Whether you relate to them or something of these have happened to you. All right, so the second one is try to have contact with your family or your friends, okay? That meaning, of course, in a relationship, some people get to the stage where they've met your mother, your dad, your sister, your brother, cousins, you know what I mean? You brought them over to family holidays and dinners and stuff like that, even graduations and, you know, different family stuff, you know what I mean? You're trying to build with that person, you're trying to bring them in, and y'all are family, coming to the family events. That means they have to stop, you know what I mean? And your family have to respect that too. Like, this is just awkward at that point where you're still talking to my ex. What do you have to talk about? Okay, you have the weather and other shit like that, but at the end of the day, my name is gonna pop up because that's where you know them from, you know what I mean? So it's kind of weird. It's like, why are you still talking to my mother? Why are you talking to my brother? Why are you talking to my cousins, my aunts, and whoever, my nephew, whoever? Leave the contact. And for the friends, okay, you have mutual friends where you guys either met friends before and you guys have the same friends. I'm not talking about those. I'm talking about the friends that are your friends. And you introduce him or her to your friends. And now they're acting like they still have this major friendly contact with them. And you got some people who don't even want you to have friends in a relationship, so that's a lie. You get what I'm saying? So that's weird in its own, but you know what I mean? Exes do that. The next one is always trying to hit you up. Whether they come with this bullcrap excuse of they sick, they got something going on, it's a problem, they have to always hit you up, or I was just checking on you. You didn't care about to check on me when I was in the relationship. You didn't check on my feelings when you were doing certain shit. You didn't care. It's just weird how exes have so much and can be such a this person you thought they were going to be in a relationship, and now they can be that outside of it. It's just weird. But yeah, they always try to find a way to hit you up. Whether they try to tell other people to contact you, whether they try to tell mutual friends, like I said before, rather try to still talk to your family and try to tell them to hit you up. Or, you know, it's just weird. Like, your ex is done. If we don't have that mutual agreement to where we're still friends and you know that, it's no reason for you to act like this suspicious Sherlock Holmes way to still find connection to me. You get what I mean? You wouldn't have to do that because why are we in contact? What's the problem? But if you know that, stop being a creep. You know what I mean? But let me get into the fourth one. Act like they're better without you and much happier. You know what I'm saying? I know everybody had an ex. Even like I said, you catch back up. Let's say you did actually link up or hit them back up after they were trying to reach out to you, like in the first post. You know what I mean? Okay. Hey, what's up? How you doing? Oh, I'm doing great. I'm making this money. I'm protecting my energy and all. You know, it's just a whole bunch of blah, blah, blah stuff. The stuff that they never even exerted in y'all relationship. You don't even know where this person came from. Now they big can go to work. Now they big can be a good person. Now they know good energy. Y'all might have been going at it every time about spits and spats and stuff, having negative energy the whole relationship. Now they know to protect the vibe, and now they know how to love more. And now they just, their opportunities in life are just opening up because you left. That's great. but it just makes no sense because I don't talk to everybody I talk to. I don't act like, yeah, I'm doing this and I'm doing that. Like, they want you to make it seem like you were the one that held them up, or they ain't tripping because I'm doing way better without, you know, you being with me and all that stuff like that. So that's just bull crap in itself. And if you are doing good, don't talk to me like that, because I was in a relationship with you. I've seen you want to do good. I've tried to push you to do good. I'm not your enemy. You hear what I'm saying? But like I said, that's a bunch of bull crap too. Okay, and the fifth one, act like they can live without you. That kind of ties into them acting like they can do better without you, or they're doing bigger things without you. But you know how you break up with somebody. I don't know if you guys have social media. Some people don't. But the people who do have social media, and like I said, you didn't delete your ex or something like that, it's not that big of an issue to you to keep them on your page. So you see them make a post, yeah, finna turn up, party, do all this stuff like that, or whatever year you're in, whether you 2019, I protected my energy, I'ma fuck hoes, get money, fuck niggas, get money. You know that whole rundown speech of when, you know, obviously they're touched. You know what I mean? Touched by the breakup. So that's one of the things that kind of like, it's weird to me too. So, but I got some bonus ones for you. If those didn't hit it, I got two bonus ones. Maybe you probably had some run in or know a friend. You know what I mean? These five things that exes do. Maybe you've never been in a relationship, but you may have seen your friend go through something, and maybe this can kind of tie into her or him. Some bonus ones is they try to mess up your new relationship. They see that you're happy. Whether some exes like to rush into another relationship to act like they've always had somebody on the side, to try to put something in your head that they weren't just on you, or you weren't their main love, or, you know what I mean, you weren't giving all their attention wasn't to you. You get what I'm saying? And then you got people who are mad that maybe they feel that when you moved on, that happened to them. You get what I'm saying? So they want to come and be like, well, hey, what's up? How you and your new boo? Did you tell your boyfriend or your girlfriend about us? Or don't get your little boyfriend or your girlfriend hurt. And you know I always love you. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that is like crazy. Because at the end of the day, the person you with now is going to be like, wow, they could just come in to talk to you whenever and let them. They could explain their love for you, and obviously, they got something big. Y'all need to help rekindle that. That brings strife, and then the ex know what they're doing. Because if they were with you, somebody else did that with you, they would want to have a problem or break up or whatever like that. Everybody knows that. But the last bonus one I'm going to say is act like they still need closure. Okay. Closure is in why you guys broke up. What was the reason? Why you guys got to that point, or why did you do them a certain type of way, or you know what I mean? Just the whole question of why did we break up? Why couldn't we get it together? Or why didn't we last? Or you know what I mean? Just a whole bunch of questions of closure. You don't need any closure. The closure you need is when I close that relationship door. That's all. And if you don't realize what you did in a relationship, if you don't realize that, that's it. And it's not for you to realize anything. We're done. Stop being a stalker. Stop being a weirdo. Move on. Move on. I'm not going to be your last, and I'm damn sure not going to be the only one that you'll need closure from in your life. A lot of stuff going to go on. Relationships, don't never ask for closure. You can get anything. You can get any answer from that. Don't let nobody play with your mind and your heart. You know what I mean? With that whole ordeal. But like I said, this was highly requested. And if y'all like some more of these videos or more topics, let me know down below. Comment, like, subscribe, and tell me what y'all think. Let me know if y'all have been through any of these five exes, things that they do, or any of the bonus ones. And hit me up. And like I said, subscribe to the channel. Turn your alert notification on so y'all can know every time I post. And y'all can get some of these lovely videos. Like I said, this is So Wavy Life coming at y'all with a whole nother video. And y'all stay tuned. Peace.